Hey, what's up everybody? TH here, and today I've got something super exciting to share with you. You know, we have all been there when you spend hours crafting the perfect cinematic masterpiece, but the struggle is real when it comes to sharing on a different platforms. The awkward cropping can totally kill the vibe. But fear not, my friends, cause today I'm going to drop Premiere Pro knowledge bombs on you, and we're going to dive deep into the world of auto reframe. So buckle up, hit the like button, and let's make your videos look epic on any screen, any platform, every single time. So this is method number one. Let's assume that you're working on your Instagram sequence and you have this clip and you want to reframe it. So you can see the girl is moving from one side of the screen to another. In order to reframe this, go to the effects and search for the reframe and drag this auto reframe to our clip and wait for a couple seconds so Premiere will analyze and reframe it for us. So we can see that the girl is perfectly tracked and this is 9:16 aspect ratio. If you don't like the tracking, you can go to the effects and go to the auto reframe and change the tracking mode to slower motion or faster motion, respectively, if you have slower motion or faster motion. The default will work for the majority of the cases. If you don't like the generated keyframes, you can click here, override generated path, and you can manipulate the keyframes. What if that you already have existing sequence that you need to reframe? In order to do that, go to the sequence, right click, go to the auto reframe, and in here, it will create a new sequence. You can name it whatever and change the aspect ratio. For example, I want to go, I don't know, square, 1:1. And again, motion tracking options. You have three options here: slower motion, default, faster motion. Leave it on default. And there's two new options. Do not nest clips. This will replace your current motion adjustment. So if you have keyframes, you should go with nesting your clips. This will keep motion adjustments, but remove transitions. I don't have anything, so I will go with the first option and will click create. So you can see this is perfectly reframed, tracked, and ready to be exported. So now you know how to reframe your footage for Instagram or TikTok or any other social media and do it automatically. Let me know what you want to see next. And as always, I will catch you in the next one. Till then, stay awesome.